say something?
First down to the police, and I'm a pull the plug.
What, you can't keep up? What, am I grounded? Do I gotta go to prison?
What am I gonna do with you?
There's nothing to do, Daddy. This is it.
3 years ago,
five seniors died in a car crash coming home from a dance, and that's when the whole town went crazy.
You want to go out and get some cheap thrills? You do it outside of Beaumont.
Thinking I could do something. Maybe have a shot at making a change.
I don't want you to see that boy.
Why?
Because I've heard he's trouble.
Watch that attitude, son.
We speak for this town because we are from here.
I know you got to do what you got to do, but that ain't going to stop it from happening.
There was once a time for that wall, but not anymore. This is our time.
We can come here to dance.
Hi, everybody. I'm Crandall.
I'm Mercy.
We are Armchair Directors.
And we're about to kick off our Sunday shoots, because we are doing the original Footloose and the new remake Footloose, new in theaters. We're going to start off with the new theatrical Footloose. And it's very rare that I have seen a remake that is better than the original in almost every single possible way.
This is a remake that a lot of people were screaming blasphemy and unnecessary. But the director of Hustle and Flow has taken his unique, grimy sort of grounded style and brought it to this outlandish story of a town that bans dancing and made it a really fun, relatable, entertaining movie.
Mm-hmm. Every single aspect. We just recently watched the original for the show.
Yeah.
And it was hard to get through in quite a few points because it is kind of suffering from 80s cheesiness.
80s syndrome.
But there are so many key elements. The thing about this movie is that it pays a lot of reverence and respect to the original.
It really does.
It never makes fun of the original, even though the original is cheesy.
Yeah.
It always pays respect to it, and it always tries to improve on it. So there's a scene like where Ren is in the original dancing. He's just so mad. He's got to go dance at the mill or at the factory. And they could have easily made fun of how cheesy that is, but they gave it their best shot to try to improve on it and pay homage to it. Musical cues show up throughout the entire movie. Mm-hmm. I'm Holding Out for a Hero guitar riff.
Yeah.
It keeps going on and on. And older story elements are improved upon, like Ren's mother has now passed away from leukemia, whereas in the original one, she was just kind of a fifth wheel,
right,
hanging around, and she did absolutely nothing. This time, her being gone gives Ren a real weight that he carries around with him.
Mm-hmm.
And it also helps him connect with Dennis Quaid's preacher character, since they've both lost someone very special to them. And also the intro of the movie actually starts with the ill-fated car crash that you hear about the entire old movie, but
right,
you never really saw it. Seeing it, and in the context that you see it in this movie, is really, really impactful.
Yeah, because it seemed like in the old one, you know, it was 8 years later, and in this one it's only 3 years later. It seemed like something you'd never, ever really needed to see. But now that we see these teens at the very beginning, they're dancing, they're partying, they're drinking, and then we see this horrible car accident that takes their lives. It makes more sense when the town bans drinking, dancing, yeah, because we've seen this car wreck, and it makes it more believable the way that it's presented, that this town has decided to put a stop to this stuff that took their children from them.
Mm-hmm.
And the fact that it's only been 3 years instead of a lot more distant makes a lot more sense when it comes to the preacher and his daughter acting out and rebelling against, you know, everything her father is trying to sort of lock down. Because in the original, there's such a gap between her and her dead brother that some of her risky behavior seems a little unbelievable.
Yeah.
And in this movie, just by changing the timeline and presenting everything to us, it makes it so much more grounded.
Yeah, like as in the original one where Ren is arguing against the bill, and they do it in this one as well.
Mm-hmm.
There's a time to mourn and there's a time to dance. And having the time span shortened in the new one works a lot better than in the old one where it just felt ridiculous.
Right.
Like they were following this stupid, outdated, stubborn law. In the new one, it just feels more real. It feels better. The cast in this one's fantastic too.
Yeah.
Across the board, everyone's great. This kid, Kenny Wormald?
Yeah.
Wormald? looks a lot like Johnny Depp, right? So right off the bat, you know there's going to be something special about him. But fantastic acting talent. I really liked him more than Kevin Bacon.
Mm-hmm.
He's got a real mischievousness about him.
He does. He's always sort of got this
twinkle in
it. Yeah, head. Sort of like he's up to something, but he's very charismatic. And certainly he does a good job to carry the early parts of the movie, because it really, if we aren't on Team Ren, it's just going to sort of fall apart because we spend so much time with the guy.
Yep. And Dennis Quaid, for the first time in probably a decade or more, is actually acting in this movie.
Yeah.
He doesn't just show up and be Dennis Quaid. He's playing a prim and proper character. Your behavior is unacceptable, young lady.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not a huge stretch, but it's just so nice to see a huge talent like Dennis Quaid. I'm a big Quaid fan. See him actually have something to work with and stretch his acting talents.
Yeah, and Julianne Hough from Dancing with the Stars, she's not bad. She's definitely sexy enough for this movie.
Yeah.
There are some shots where the camera's just practically oogling her.
Yeah.
But I have no complaints in that department.
Mm-hmm. All right, time for best part.
Worst part.
Best part is Willard, which we'll get to it in the Kevin Bacon version. But the character Willard is just as hilarious in this one as he was in the original one, played by the late Chris Penn.
Mm-hmm.
Very charismatic, very hilarious. His chemistry with Ren, right off the bat, instantly, bam.
Yeah, is great.
Is fantastic. And again, improved upon over the old one. In the old one, he had a few moments where he's this just kind of knuckle-dragging idiot, and you're kind of disappointed in him. He never really upsets you that much in this one. He's just a really good-hearted country bumpkin with a heart of gold. Worst part is that I just gotta dance scene. The scene where Ren just can't take it anymore.
Yeah.
He drives his car and smashes the door, and he's just gotta dance.
Gotta dance.
Now, they tried their heart out to try to make it work. They had him get hurt. He falls. He hurts himself, smashes, falls off a chain. He's smashing things. He's tearing wood off and breaking windows. So they tried their best. I gotta tip my hat to them for the effort.
Yeah.
It still didn't work. It was still silly. When people are that upset, they don't go dance. It doesn't matter how passionate you are. If you're passionate about, you know, piano playing or guitar or whatever, you don't go and do the thing that you love to do when you're upset.
Right.
You go and you scream and you smash things. You don't dance or play piano while you're smashing.
Right. I'm going to say, worst part, you know, I really like that they do change a lot of stuff, but then the beats are still so slavish to the original Footloose that in the last 20 minutes, I feel like you can cut out a good 5 to 8 minutes that are sort of superfluous.
That fight.
And move us to the ending. So the movie did so much right that then right near the end, it just starts to drag before we get to the final dance scene.
That fight is awful.
So yeah, specifically the fight. So that's worst part is that in that last little bit, they could have used a little bit of editing. Best part, the dance numbers are awesome.
Mm-hmm.
When they go to the drive-in and they have this sort of, you know, dance-off sort of going on, it's really down and dirty, and you see why these teens are dancing and how dancing really is sort of like a behind closed doors secret thing that they like to do. Whereas in the original, everybody all of a sudden knows how to dance, even though we never really see anybody other than the core characters like dancing in secret. So I really like that. And you mentioned Willard was great. He was awesome. Especially the Let's Hear It for the Boy
sequence
was so well done in this one.
Yeah.
Really great, especially with the little kids.
Absolutely. All right, so that is a definite must-see.
Yeah.
And I'm very surprised to say that because I was not looking forward to seeing the movie at all, but it won me over. It was fun, inspirational, lighthearted, great story. Don't let the whole concept of it being Footloose.
Yeah, if you're very, you know, tepid and resistant to it, go see it. You're going to have a lot of fun. Craig Brewer really did a great job here.
We'll be right back with the original Footloose.
Come on, before we crack, lose your blues.
Welcome back to Armchair Directors. For our second review, we're going to do the original 1984 Footloose. And this one has
where it all began. Where it all began.
And we're children of the 80s, so nostalgia plays a big part.
It goes a long way with a movie like this, that's for sure.
Yeah, it didn't go very far for me, though. This thing hasn't aged very well, in my opinion. And I know there's a lot of people who are very, very passionate about Footloose. Yep. But watch it, you know? Instead of just, I remember it being great. Why don't you watch it? And then tell me how great you think it is.
You weren't on the edge of your seat for the tractor battle where they play chicken and Ren gets his shoelace stuck and that's the only reason he wins the battle. That's like a 5-minute scene of tractors coming together.
I'm all in out for a hero. I'm all in out for a hero till the end of the night. It's much better in the new one where they homage the tractor. They made you think for a second it'll be tractors again, but then it's buses.
Yeah.
Kevin Bacon's great in it. This is one of his first major starring roles.
Mm-hmm.
But again, I can't help but think that Kenny Wormald is better.
So it's funny because, you know, we didn't talk too much about the overall story in our remake review because we hopefully you know it. But Footloose is about this rebel kid, Ren, who comes to the town of Beaumont, who has banned dancing.
Yep.
And he just can't believe that dancing isn't allowed. Because he likes to go dancing.
Because it's evil and it led to the tragic accident that killed a bunch of young people, including the pastor's son.
So he falls in love with the pastor's daughter, but he wants to take down this dancing ban. And he goes out of his way to make sure that the kids of Beaumont can kick off their Sunday shoes and cut foot loose whenever they want.
Mm-hmm.
A little bit of a ridiculous premise that dancing would be outlawed.
Well, it shows you how 80s it is, right?
Now, so we see this small town, and in this original one, the town is a little bit nuts. There is a moment, for no reason, where they start burning books because they find them offensive. Somebody talks about how Slaughterhouse-Five by Kurt Vonnegut is just the worst thing that anybody could read.
It is the most spontaneous, sudden book burning I have seen in any movie ever.
So maybe in some of these parts of the States in the 80s, this seemed like something rational. But watching this movie now, you're like, I don't think anywhere would just start an out-of-the-blue book burning.
Yeah.
So it really takes you out of the movie thinking, like, were things really that severe in the 80s? But there are some good parts of this movie, Kevin Bacon being one of them.
Chris Penn.
R.I.P. He was great, you know, as Willard. Very funny and charming, even though he's sort of doing a dumb redneck the whole time.
He's got that awesome southern charm to him, you know, the southern gentleman. And they did it in the new one, too. When they first meet, it looks like it's going to be the formulaic, okay, these guys are going to be nemesis.
Yeah, they're going to hate each other. Yeah.
Nemesis is throughout the entire movie. But just like in the new one, like they turn a corner immediately and become the best of friends right away. So, you know, that was cool. There's quite a few things that are good in this one, and I'm glad to see them make their way in the new one. But there's some stuff that I thought wasn't that good. Like John Lithgow. I love John Lithgow. But I just felt like he was holding back the entire movie. Maybe he was playing it as brokenhearted because his son had died.
Mm-hmm.
But we know John Lithgow can turn up the volume and just project and be larger than life.
Yeah.
So to see him just very quiet and introspective and doubting everything is not John Lithgow. It's a waste of talent.
Well, and then he gets some moments where, like, you know, he has a bit of that Lithgow fire when he's reading some parts of the Bible at the beginning, or when he slaps Ariel in the face, which, you know, she got off easy compared to the Trinity killer, you know?
That's right.
So, but moments like that are kind of like, oh my goodness, like, there are a few questionable scenes, I think, in this movie.
She takes a beating from her boyfriend.
Yeah.
And in the new one, they tone that down quite a bit.
Right.
I mean, she gets smacked around a little bit, but in this one, it's brutal.
Yeah.
Like, again, 80s movies are strange in that way, because there are some Spielberg movies, too, where you think, this was in a PG movie? Or
yeah. So there are a few moments like that where certainly the ratings board has shaped the way that movies are made now compared to back then. But the main thing about Footloose is just the charm and the music and the dancing and all that stuff is still fun, even though this movie feels overly long and a little bit, if you don't have nostalgia for it, you're just going to be rolling your eyes nonstop.
Yeah, one thing that has aged exceptionally well is the music. It's all great, great music choice in this movie, and that theme will never get old.
That's for sure.
Time for best part.
Worst part. Best part, the music. Let's hear it for the boy, Footloose, I Need a Hero. All these songs are classic 80s songs. Most of them came from this movie, and I could listen to Kenny Loggins' Footloose any day of the week, and you'll be wanting to tap your toe and still watching it. Every time they play these songs, you're like, yeah, these songs, just so fun. Now, maybe the only one that's not super classic is the one that they play dancing in the sheets and everybody's like at the arcade machine, start grooving, and that song is just kind of okay.
Yeah.
Worst part, the length of this movie. The pacing is off. Watching it now, the last half an hour felt like an hour.
Yeah. They should have cut loose 20 minutes.
Yeah.
My worst part is just as in the remake, that I just got a dance scene.
Yep.
It doesn't work.
Rage dancing, not your thing.
Yeah. Best part is, once again, Willard. Chris Penn is fantastic, hilarious, charming. Best part of this movie for me.
Mm-hmm. So, there you have it. You either cut loose with Footloose or you don't.
And I would recommend actually seeing the original before you see the remake, because the reverence and the stuff they reference is cool. And Footloose, now on Blu-ray, if you pick it up, you get an $8 off your movie ticket at the theater. So that's not a bad deal at all.
All right.
We'll be right back with Douba Douba. Welcome back to Armchair Directors for our final segment. We're going to be doing a music video that I recently did with Khoren, Mouradian. And coincidentally, it's called Douba Douba, which is Armenian for Footloose.
No, it's not.
All right, so enjoy the video. Ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba ba
Yellaz hoknats tkhrats inchkan sirunes karmir masov gabudachkov im sirtes kayre
Dubadubadumba hayde tsaptsape Dubadubadumba dubadubadumba hayde kefer Dubadubadumba dubadubadumba gyanke bayle Dubadubadumba ordore
Duba dumba la duba da ba da shta, shayde zap zap. Duba dumba la duba da ba da shta, shayde kefare. Duba dumba la duba da ba da shta, inch kele tiges. Dumba la da ba da ba da shta, orer orer. de gur sirunach chik modas kepaneng yanka sude yerkeng pareng khmeng payeleng genatsnere ber patsrasteng pogin gtmeng rumba samba salsa cha cha miasin bare
duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba haide zap zap duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba haide kefere duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba yanka bayle rumba da dumba da dumba da dumba ore ore ore
duba duba dumba da duba da ba dash dash haide zap zap duba duba dumba da duba da ba dash dash haide kefere duba duba dumba da duba da ba dash dash inch gerezi des dumba da dumba da ba da ba dash dash ore ore ore
vamos a flamenco
ya está
duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba dumba da dumba da Duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba dumba da dumba da Duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba dumba da dumba da Dumba da dumba da dumba da dumba dumba da dumba da
Duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba haide zap zap
Duba duba dumba da duba da ba dash dash haide kefare
Duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba yanke bayle Rumba da dumba da dumba da dumba ore ore ore Dumba da dumba, ore ore ore.
Vamos a flamenco,
ya está.
Duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba, dumba da dumba da. Duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba, dumba da dumba.
So that was Douba Douba, which means footloose in Armenian. No, it doesn't. So I'm going to do a quick best part, worst part for this. Best part was working with Khoren, who produced it. Fantastic. He got all the people together, all of the places, all of the cool toys.
Yeah.
Like the Ferrari.
Yeah, the cool cars.
All that stuff. True pro. Laid back, but a hard worker. You know?
That's the best kind.
Absolutely. Worst part, we had a diva on the shoot. I'm not going to specify who it was. But for the sake of people not watching the video and wondering, was it her? Was it her? I will say that she was blonde. And she's one of the two main girls.
So, can you guess who it was? Everybody's going to rewind this on the DVR and try and figure out who was the diva.
Good luck with that. So thanks a lot for watching, and until next time,
Douba Douba.
Karnan amran aşnat zımran miştan uşi gez Arduk esor yere goyan im sirte gayres Nıstat yellat hoknat tıkrat inç kan sirunes Karmir masov kabuy daçkov im sirte skayres
Duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba haydi zap zap Duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba haydi kefere Duba duba dumba da duba duba dumba Yankı bayle Rumba da dumba da dumba da dumba Ora dora re
Duba duba dumba la duba da badaş daş Haydi zap zap e Duba duba dumba la duba da badaş daş Haydi kefare Duba duba dumba la duba da badaş daş İnç gelet zides Dumba la dumba la daba da badaş daş Ora